Welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demo on Universal Embedded Trainer with PIC18F microchip families. We are going to see the different working of microchip 18F4520 as a daughter board connected on the Universal Embedded Trainer with lot of applications to be used. See the programming and development of different type of codings. I will also explain you the complete installation of compiler software, then we will burn the hex files on the microchip and later on we will perform some experiments with the optional and provided applications like 7 segment LEDs, input output flip switches and LCD screen, buzzers and relay. There are a lot of applications on the board which are on boardly provided with this trainer board. Let us move on to the kit description, what are the main applications and the onboard circuits are provided for this, and also we will be study about the basic of microchip programming and later on we will see some experiment program on the trainer. So this is the complete package of the trainer kit. The order code is 43514 with the complete setup of daughter board. Now I will open the front cover of this complete trainer kit. This is the case is provided with this to prevent it from the dust of and any other hazardous equipment, so that daughter board and all onboard component will be remain safe. And this is the complete setup with different type of application. If you include the daughter board provided on it, the order code is the 43514, the universal embedded trainer with the microchip PIC CPU card, and the rest of the complete setup without the daughter board is known as 43511 universal embedded trainer only. So it requires to combine both the order code for this, whether the complete trainer board is useful with different type of applications of daughter boards, so that you can connect and include different type of daughter boards in the complete setup. So for this we are using the PIC kit CPU card with the 18F family. So we are describing about this. First we will describe about the accessories which required with this. This is the RS232 serial communication cable which is provided with this to communicate and programming the different aspects of this complete trainer. This is the USB cable for connecting the complete trainer kit with the USB setup to communicate it and to run the program and download the program on the microchip over here. This is the user manual in which all the details study about the microchip processing and the functioning of all the block diagrams of microchip are provided in which, and this is the power connecting code so that you can power on the circuit with the power supply of 220 volt AC. Then on the other hand we are also providing the programmer setup. This is the PIC USB programmer. This is required to communicate with the, this is the JTAG type of cable provided with this. So one end of this cable for the ISP programming is provided to connect on this, and the other end will be connected with the USB provided as we described. So this is the programmer which required to communicate it with the PC. So we'll use this. These are the three LEDs for power, USB and BG signal. This can be described while working. And now we move on to the all description of these components. Now we start with the complete description of all the boards are provided. So this is the CPU, microchip 18F452 series operating at 4 megahertz of the speed, and this is the on chip 32 KB flash memory and 1536 byte RAM are provided. And then we have on chip 256 bytes EEP ROM and on chip UART, SPI, I2C and PWM working, and on chip 8 channel 10 bit ADC are provided. So these are completely provided on the single chip connected. And then we have on chip 32 IO lines in the 40 pin connectors are also provided. Discussing about the applications, we have 16 LED to display the digital outputs, 16 switches to give the digital inputs with the indication LEDs as well. Then we have 16x2 alphanumeric LCD backlit display. Then we have 4x4 matrix keyboard for different keyboard inputs. Then we have miniature buzzer, 12 volt SPDT relays, NONC and common terminals are also provided. Then we have 4 digit 7 segment display over here, IT2C compatible 24C512 EP ROM is also provided. Then we have DS1307RTC with suitable battery is also provided. Battery is connected behind the daughter board. 4 channel 8 bit ADC and 1 channel 8 bit DAC using PCFET591IC. Then we have temperature sensor interface using LM35 is provided. Also temperature sensor interface using DS18B20 is also provided. Also the 24 IO lines are provided on a 26 pin FRC connector for external interface. So we can connect different type of external interfaces, optional are provided, and onboard supply of 12 volt, 5 volt. Then we have 3.3 volt, 2.5 volt, 1.5 volt and 1.2 volt is provided with all the LEDs with different type of intensity LEDs. We'll describe that the different values of voltages are generated inside it. Also we have the indication switches for different type of daughter board connected on this. So when we turn on the PC complete piece, the LED which is mentioned as the PIC pick is light up, so that it indicates that the daughter board of PIC microchip is connected on the complete trainer setup. Switches which are need to be in completely off conditions are switch 1. All the dip switches need to be in off condition before programming it, and at the switches which are required to different programming sections will be setup and combination of different switches are required for complete work with the different applications. So we'll turn off all the switches on the dip switch 1, dip switch 2 and also the dip switch 3. The dip switch 3 is provided for I2C and relay and buzzer. So we required to turn on both the switches, and 1 and 2 will be dependent on the application that we are using. Then the switch 3 which will be in off condition when we are going to use the temperature sensor, this will be turned on. Rest of that, switch 4, switch 5, switch 6 and switch 7 on the daughter board will be in off condition while working with. Then switch 3 is at the release position for working with the applications. When you press it, it will ready to be programmed. Reset switch, onboard reset switch is also provided. Then this is the JTAG connector for 10 pin that will be connected with the programmer board that we are providing with this for programming. We'll power on the trainer kit connected with the PC and let us install the required softwares for programming the chip. Now for setting up the complete trainer board with the power and the programming, first connect the power socket to the upper right end that you have connected the power socket. Turn on the on-off switch. Here some LEDs will start glowing. This will show 5 volt, 3.3 volt, 2.5 volt, 1.5 volt and 1.2 volts are generated, and the LCD screen will light up and give you some message. We'll see it. Now for connecting it with the programmer, make sure to use the proper cables provided with the kit only. And now this is the 10 pin FRC cable for JTAG connector that we are going to use. One end at the programmer section and other end at the daughter board that we need to connect. And for connecting it with the PC, we'll connect one end of the USB cable to the programmer and other end will be connected on the USB port of the PC. As I connected the USB to USB port of PC, here you can see the USB port or light is continuously on in proper manner. It's showing that the kit is connected to the PC. After doing this setup, we move on to the computer section. Here we will install the software for programming, and later on we will program the complete microchip with different sample programs. Now after opening the CD folder in your PC, you will find the folders containing like that. So this is a zip file in which all the tools and folders are included. So we'll extract this. You can extract it at your desired location. I am extracting it in this same folder. All the tools and installer folders will be installed automatically. After extracting the all folders, you will find a folder like this, PAC-PIC-18A45-20. So we'll go to this folder in which three folders are provided: code, documents and tools folder. In the tools folder, there are different tools which are required to install for working on the kit. Then turn back, in the front you will find the .NET FX folder, in which if you run this .NET FX file, this will configure your PC to the required .NET framework which is required to install to run the PIC downloader. So I have already configured my PC with this. So if the PC is not configured, it will automatically install the .NET FX 3.5 or lower than that. The tool PIC-KIT 2 version 2.61 requires the .NET framework lower than the 3.5, so it is ready. Now we'll install the PIC-KIT 2 software in the PC for downloading the hex codes in our kit. Now after installing the .NET framework less than 3.5, in which you will require to include the 2.0 framework also, this will work, the software will work on 2.0, so we require to install the 3.5 or lower than that. So we are now ready to install the PIC-KIT 2 software. So we'll double click on that. Here we'll press next. Again press next. You can also browse the desired location where you want to install the software. Agree the license terms, and it will start installing the microchip software in your PC. So installation is now completed. You can go to desktop, and over here we can see this is the icon of PIC-KIT 2, which is our downloading tool software, which is ready right now. Here this is the PIC-KIT 2 programmer, is completely ready to download the hex file in our kit. But we also install the compiler software, which is also provided with the complete CD folders. So we now go to compiler software. In the tools, MPLAB is our compiler software, so we will install this also. Now we are ready to install the MPLAB compiler, which is required to compile the codes in the complete software and PC kit. So we'll install this. Open this folder. Here you will find the installer file. Run this file and this will start installing the MPLAB software in your PC. This is the microchip powered software. Accept the license agreement. So we'll install this. It will take some time to properly install in your PC, and then we'll ready to do the compilation, and then we see some codes programmed on the our MPLAB software is ready to be installed. It will like to install the other softwares also, so install them with the complete installation.
and then we will ready to do the compilations for the codes. Here it is completing the installation. Here our complete installations are done. Press finish. This is the site of Microchip. Here all the resistance and document license are provided. Now at our desktop we have find the software MPLAB XDE. So we'll turn it on. So this is the main welcome window of MPLAB compiler. Now we also need to install the compilation support software. For this XE8 need to install. You will open the XE8 compiler. The compiler will be given in the folder. So we'll install this as well. Press yes. And as you start installing, you will find this will install the compiler XE8 C compiler. So we require to install this for compiling the C codes. Required to run the evaluation license free mode. Now setup is ready to install the compiler XE8 for C compiling in your PC. So we have now installing the MPLAB XE8 C compiler. So installation is now about to complete. It will take about 2 to 3 minutes for completely installing, and here it's creating the shortcuts for the compiler. Here creating an installer, and this is now about to done. So these are the readme files for activation and other processes. So XE8 compiler for C compiling is also installed on our PC. Now we are ready to work and compile the C codes with the MPLAB XD software.
After starting the MPLAB, you will find this window as described over here. So here you can create a new project like this and select the microchip, whatever the microchip you want to use, and some other embedded programs that we are required. Now I will show you sample example in the project already that I am working on it. So this is the character LCD project that we have created for your sample. So this is the basic, all the welcome window and start page over here. And for the main C compilation file, if we go to this main C file, here you can see this is the complete main C files. These are the different included characteristics and complete C codes for the message signal, which is welcome to Tesca Technologies Jaipur embedded trainer. This will start flashing on the LCD screen. It is designed as per the function given. So these are the complete navigator and character LCD screen. You can use this complete software for compiling your different codes for different values. Now we open the PicKit software in which we will turn on the programming. The already coded hex files will be downloaded with the PicKit 2 software over here. So this is the PicKit 2 software that we are going to open. Here, as I open this, we have connected our PicKit to the PC, so it is showing that PicKit 2 is found and connected. Now here we can select the device family from this. So we are working with PicKit 18F family, so we'll select 18F over here. Select the part number, which is 18F4520. As I have selected this, so PicKit is ready to download the files. Now we'll import the hex file from the file over here and from the complete CD folder in which we have provided all the codes. This is the pack PicKit. Go to code folder. These are the different codes that is provided for programming purpose, and the sample programs are already created in them. So for this, we'll first do the sample program given in the user manual, which is 7-segment LED program. So we'll open the 7-segment LED one. Here, this is the 7-segment program given in the folder. Open this, go to DIST folder, default production, and here will we find the hex file of 7-segment production. Select this, open this, and this will show you message hex file is successfully imported. After this, now we are ready to download it on the kit. Now before installing the complete file and downloading the file on the data or the kit, so make sure all the switches on the dip switches section will be in off condition before writing the program on the microchip. So we'll now ready to write the program. All the switches are now off, in the off condition as described in the user manual, and now we can write this program. So we'll press write over here. It will start writing the memory, verifying the device memory, and programming successful will be shown as the green indication. Now we can move to the kit and see the program as per the user manual. File definitions, all the switch position will be changed according to the user manual given, and then we see the program described for this.
Now for development and for the sample programming, we have provided some sample program already created with the code files, which will be provided in the software CD, and these are some sample program that we are going to perform right now in this video for the explanation. So in the user manual, this is the table over here given for the different sample programs which is already created, need to be write up on the flash memory of the PicKit. And as given in the switch position and settings, we need to require to do all the settings on the application board to perform the example. So first we will do the 7 segment example over here. We will download this from the PC on the trainer board. Then we have to select on the switch 1, 5, 6 and 7 number dip switch in the on condition and rest of the other switches in the off condition. Then switch 2 should be off, switch 3 should be off condition, and at the switch 4 we will need to on none of the switches, rest of the switches will be in off condition. Then jumper position need to be 2 and 3 for jumper 1, 2, 3 and 4 respectively. Other jumper settings need to be changed in some other examples, we will also see them, but before we will do the 7 segment sample exam. So in this example, as we are downloading it from the programming software, we will get to see the good message on this 4 digit 7 segment LED samples. So now we are going to download the program from the programming software. As I am going to download the program, you will see some changes on the programmer as well. The BC indications will be light up, power indication will be light up when we provide the power from the trainer board. So now I am going to write up this. Before, make sure all the switches on the dip switch 1 section should be in off condition. Switches on the daughter board need to be in off condition. Switches 2 will be in off condition, and switch 3 which is already off, and switch 4, the requirement of I2C is not need to be on, but rest of the switches will be in off condition. So before programming, we need to make sure all the switch position and the switch 3 which is in the depressed position for programming it. When we do programming, we will release this, and after that we will see the output. Now I write the program. As I am writing the program, the LED is blinking and giving me the programming BC indication, power indication to the program. Now we will release the switch SW3, change the position of switch 1 dip switches. So we need to turn on the 5, 6 and 7 number pin. So we will turn on 5, 6 and 7 number pin, and as I press reset, okay, 5 numbers pin is not properly on in this case. Now as I turn on the 5th number pin properly, we can see the good message on the 7 segment screen. So that's how this is coded, generated in the and programmed in the PIC memory, and we have got the application output on the 7 segment LCD. For the next example, we will do the programming for LCD screen. The complete setup message is already coded in the program as LCD screen. The message will be displayed on the 16:2 LCD display, and we will read this according to our code. So we'll download the code. Make sure switches again we need to turn off in all the condition before downloading and writing any of the program. So we have turned off all the switches in the normal condition. No good message on the 7 segment LEDs. This is now in completely off condition. Now we'll burn up the program on the microchip PIC18F series, and then we set up for getting the output on the LCD screen.
So in the similar manner, we can download the another program as well. For this, just go to File, Import Hacks, and for the next program, we can download the other one, which is LCD display. The LCD display or character LCD, the same program here. This one is the character LCD or LCD display one program. So we'll select this, open dist default folder, production folder, then here this is the hex file, and press open over here and press write to program and flashing the complete setup in the microchip. That's how our second program is downloaded. You can follow the same procedure as I described in this for all the files memories given. You will see all the examples one by one on the trainer kit.
After downloading the program, we'll release the switch S3, press reset, and now we'll turn on LCD switches 1, 2 and 3 as described in the user manual. So we'll turn on LCD switch 1, 2 and 3 over here and we'll press reset. And as I press reset, you will get the message, "Welcome to Tesca Technologies Jaipur, embedded trainer based on 18F4520 series." So that's how we incorporate the LCD application with the microchip provided on the daughter board. You can perform all the experiments as described, and as I am explaining the process, you can perform 16 LED input switches. Code is already given. Just need to turn on the fourth number switch on switch 1 dip switches. On 16 output LED, need to turn on the 8 number switches, as fixed pattern of the 16 output LED will be generated and coded in the codes, and you will get the output over here. Now we will see the ADC and DAC and also LM35 temperature program, in which we need to adjust the jumper position of 5 and 6 given in the user manual. So for ADC and DAC program, 1, 2 and 3 LCD switches need to be in on condition, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 will be in off condition. Switch 2 will be off, switch 3 will be off, and in the switch 4 we'll need to on the 3rd and 4th number pin of the dip switches, and 1 and 2 will be in off condition. On the jumper 1, 2 and 3 and 4, there will be no change of the pin position, but at the jumper 5 and 6, we need to change this to 2 and 3, and there is a note provided for regarding this example. The note is describing when the jumper 5 in 1 and 2 input is taken from the LM35 from the analog input 1, AIN1 of the PCF8591, and when the jumper switch is in 2 and 3 input, is a 2 and 3 pin number, input is taken from the external source for analog input. So if we want to connect any external source for providing the 5 volt supply or any other supply, and to check and calibrate it and the digital signal will be displayed on LCD, we need to change the jumper position, and for taking the output from the LM35, we need to again change the jumper position. So we'll see this according to the programming example on the trainer board. Before downloading the program, we make sure to turn off all the switches on the dip switch 1 that we have turned on for the LCD display program, and again we will push this switch 3 to the depressed position for programming it. Now we need to change the jumper position, which is at the 2 and 3. This is the jumper pipe over here. If we change this jumper to 1 and 2, this will not get the output on the AI1 input 1. This will take the output from LM35 IC over here. But in the ADC DAC case, we need to put this at 2 at 3 condition so that we can get the input from all the analog input terminals.
Now for the ADC DAC program, we'll select again follow the similar process, in which we will select I2C ADC DAC program over here, download this and write this in the complete program memory or the microchip. And now we will see how to do check all the ADC and DAC values.
After downloading the program and writing the program on the microchip, we will turn on the switch 1, 2 and 3 of the LED as described in the user manual. Here, as I turn on them, we can get the outputs analog input value on the LCD screen in the digital form. Here now you can visible it properly. All the values from all four analog inputs are showing over here. These are continuously variable because we have do not provided any of the value to any of the terminal. For this, we'll use a
patch code. For onboard supply, I'm using patch code. You can provide any other supply from 5 volts. So I've connected one end of the patch code to 5 volts. And if I put this to the AI1 connector, you can see the value of AI1 will be now stabilized. So 255 is the maximum value for this, and AI1 get the 5 volts input, and 255 is the digital output of this value. So we have converted analog signal to digital with this complete trainer setup. Now similarly, we can get the different outputs on the AI2. We are getting 255 again, as I have connected to this AI2. Now we connect this to AI3. Now again AI3 is 255. The complete 5 volts are providing at this terminal. Now for AI4, this is now 255. So that's how we have converted the analog signals in the digital form, and which is also displayed on the LCD screen. That's how this code is designed to perform this type of experiment. Now on the similar process, we will do the LM35 explanation or example also. For this, I have turned off all the LCD switches. This is now in the programming mode, as we depress the switch S3, and now we need to change the jumper position to 1 and 2 number pins. So we have changed the jumper position. Now you can see the pin 3 is open and 1 and 2 are now short circuited, so that we are now start getting the output from LM35 sensor. So we'll download the program. And later on we'll see how we get the output.
And now for the LM35 case for temperature measurement with the LM35 IC, we'll use the LM35 I2C folder in which the hex file is provided. So we'll write this again. And let us see what changes we need to do on the trainer board.
Now after downloading it and writing it on the program memory, we'll release this and turn on the LCD switches again. Here you can see the display is now changed to LM35 temperature in degrees Celsius is sensing is about 29 degree, which is the room temperature that we have sensing over here. Now if I touch the LM35 sensor, it will start sensing my body temperature on my hand, and the temperature will be sensed and displayed on the LCD screen. Here it will now increasing. This is now 31. So this is how we can convert the temperature signal with the microchip programming. So you can take any other hot object near about this sensor and get the temperature variation. Do not touch the object to the sensor, as I am just using my hand, so it can be variable for the sensor, but any other hot object can damage the sensor. So carefully use the sensor while working this type of program. Moving to next, we'll turn off the LCD switches again, turn this to on condition, and for the next program we'll now do the DS18B20 temperature sensor program. For this we need to change the switch position 3 in on condition. 1, 2 and 3 will be on, and at the switch 1 rest of the switches will be in off condition. So we'll do this program and download it on the PCB and see the output on the trainer board.
Now for DSB series temperature sensor, we'll go to again importing hex and here this is the folder DS18B20 is provided. So we again go to this folder, default folder, production. Here this is the hex file. Open this and we are ready to download it. Just press write over here. This will write the device memory and we are ready to see the output with this application. Here program is successful. Now we move to the trainer board.
After downloading it, we just need to release this switch, turn on the LCD 1, 2 and 3 switch from the switch 1 and press reset over here. So this is now change the LCD message display with one wire with configuration at 18B20 12 bit processor and temperature in degree Celsius is showing right now is 0. Before it is because we does not turn on the switch S3, so we'll turn on the switch S3 and output will be starts giving on the degree Celsius. If this is 29, about 28.937. now again if I touch this sensor, this will start sensing my body temperature and the temperature will start increasing, so it will give you the detailed output and precise output more than LM35 for the temperature value. So this is showing my body temperature continuously on the LCD screen. That's how we can incorporate different type of sensors and the process instrumentations for working with this type of microprogramming. Sample, we now see the buzzer example. Buzzer and relay will be just depend on the switch number 4. In the buzzer section we need to turn on the dip switch number 1 and at the relay section we need to turn on the switch number 2. So I am just performing the buzzer section. Relay section will be understood automatically as I perform the buzzer example. For this again we need to turn off LCD switches 1, 2 and 3. Also the sensor switch that we have turned on, switch 3, need to be in also off condition. Press this programming switch and now we are ready to perform the program.
Now for downloading the buzzer program, again go to import hex, go to code folder and we will find the buzzer program as well. This is the buzzer program provided in the codes. So similar manner, we'll download and write up this program on the flash memory. Write this and we are ready to check the output on the trainer board. So now we move to the trainer board when the program is successful. Here, so we move to the trainer board.
Writing the program, just release this button, turn on LCD screen 1, 2 and 3 value. These 1, 2 and 3 switch need to be in on condition and also we'll turn on the switch number 1 on the 4. So this is giving us the buzzer output and press reset. This will give us the output of buzzer. Similarly, for another example, we'll now download the key matrix program in which we need to turn on the switch number 2, all the switches need to be on and we'll get the output of when the key is processed and pressed, and with this will be displayed on the LCD screen. For this, all the switch need to be in off condition on the dip switch 1. Right now before downloading the program, we need to turn off all the switches in switch number 2 as well. Now we download the program in the memory and then press the switch 3 for downloading and ready the programming, and now you will see the output after downloading the program.
Now for downloading the key matrix program, go to file folder again. From the code folder, we'll find the key matrix program over here. This is the key matrix code. Go to this folder, default production, and this is the hex file for key matrix. We'll write up this on the flash memory and move to trainer board to get the output.
After writing up the program, we'll remove the switch 3 in the release position
turn on LCD screen 1, 2 and 3 switch from the LCDs. Press reset. This will now move to the keyboard selection. Keep it discovered, press a key. Right now, if I press any of the key, this will no, don't give you any of the output because all the switches in the switch 2 is in off condition. So for that, we have to first turn on all the switches from switch number 2 so that all the output from the switches will be provided on the trainer board. Now all the switches in on condition, press first key that I pressed, which is keyboard key 1, which is shown on the LCD screen. If I release this, this will show you the value is none. Similarly, if I press keyboard switch 2, this will give you keyboard switch 2. In the similar manner, it will give you 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and any other whatever you want. This is the 16th, 15th, 11th, 12th, again 6. In the no particular order, you can check the output of different keys as we pressed. So that's how you can conclude and different applications can be used from this, as I programmed different codes in this, and you can do all the programmings as described. That was the demonstration of Universal Embedded Trainer with Microchip 18F4520 with the daughter board is now completed. I have explained you the complete concept of how to program the software or the codes with the programming software. I have also explained the compiler software, how you can use and compile your own codes. The development procedure and development kit has a lot more than a scope with this. These are the some sample program that we have performed in this complete video. You can do your own programming with development or different type of codes using the onboard application, or more than that, you can connect this with the external peripheral which are also supported with this complete trainer kit. Still, if you find some difficulties while working with this complete trainer board, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. Content of this video and the programming of the embedded trainer and how to program the trainer and how you can use the different applications on this trainer is very useful for you. Press the like button, and also you can share this video to your friends, to your colleagues, to your classmates, those who want to learn about the embedded programming. You can refer the user manual also for the programming section, and complete kit very beneficial for different type of programmers who want to do development practice. So you can subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of videos for different practical information for different type of educational trainer are uploaded. So you can learn from there also for clearing your concept of different type of education topics. Don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video with our new kit, you can get the notification about that as well. And also you will get the knowledge about the new one also. So till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.